Okay, what's up, guys? It's your boy Drew Morrissey here at lovely UCLA on a nice Wednesday. And today's video is going to be about how to stay motivated and how to have confidence in the dark times of your rap career or your writing, or times that you just don't feel like you're creating the level of product you know you're capable of, or maybe that you just want to, and maybe you feel like you haven't hit your stride yet. So I wanted to answer this question because a young man reached out to me on YouTube, messaged me directly and said he was wondering about that. And today I'm gonna try something new and just talk a little bit about my experience with rap and how I got through it and the dark times and a few examples. So first, the first time I remember this happening was I was in college, I was about 18 years old, and there were some cats hating on me, you know, and they were just like, they would always, every time I was spitting in the little lobby we had there in the dorm, there was a shit on me, or like if people were saying I wasn't nice or whatever, or people were saying I was nice, they would sit there and be like, nah, fuck this dude, he whack or whatever. And I can just remember, it's a while ago now, but I can remember be like, all right, really? Okay, well, bet. I'm gonna go get my lyrics. You sit right here, and I'm gonna spit this for you right now. And if by the end of it, you say I'm whack, then that's all good, and I'll go back and get back in the lab. I run up to the dorm, literally get my printed lyrics, like on a sheet, old school style, and I spit probably like three or four songs for them. And by the end of it, they were like, I don't even like this. They said out loud, I don't even like you, dog, as a person, but that was nice. And that was a great feeling. So what can you learn from that in the dark times? First, rap is something where your competitive spirit is like one of the strongest things for you. This isn't like other parts of life where being too competitive can like really fuck you. Like, so for example, being an artist or a painter sometimes, like if you're too competitive as a painter, I assume it would probably fuck you over, or you paint worse or something. I mean, I don't know, but you know, the rap is something where competitive spirit actually helps you in your dark times. So find whatever you need to do. You know, I know that for me to this day, if I'm struggling musically, like I will be like, nah, fuck that, I'm that good, I can do this. You know, I'm more like an athlete in my brain than I am like a painter or a sculptor or any other kind of art. So where's your competitive spirit? Where's that energy that you can get so that when the guy's hating on you, you can say, all right, well, here are my lyrics, spit it, you know, that kind of thing. That's one way to sort of get through the dark times, is to access your competitive spirit. Number two, I can remember that it took me a long, long time for rap to speak for me. Meaning that, you know, from about age 14 or maybe age 16, the first couple years I was rapping, I couldn't write the songs about the things that I felt I needed to rap about. And that's where the dark times come into it, right? I'm like, I'm gonna write a verse about how hard this shit is. But it always came out sounding like Tupac or Jay-Z or whoever I was trying to emulate. So, you know, what I would do is I would write rhymes at night, like where I'd wake up out of bed and write a rhyme when I really was feeling my worst. So when you're in the dark times, the best thing you can do is write a rhyme no matter how shitty it is, because if you do that for a while, eventually your brain clicks and it says, the way to deal with this dark time is to write the rhyme. You see what I mean? Like your brain eventually answers the command where it's like, I'd rather write the rhyme than feel this dark shit, so now I'm gonna write the rhyme. So you kind of, you know, short circuit any kind of negativity that you're feeling around rapping during your dark times. So that's the number two way that you can handle it, is to practice. And the next time you feel that pain, you feel like, you know, you're not where you wanna be like, well, fuck it, I'm gonna write this rhyme until my brain finally accepts. I write music in order to deal with my shit. I don't deal with shit by avoiding writing music. So that's another way that I do it. And I can remember many times just being in bed and handwriting out shitty ass verses. I mean, they were terrible, but that's how I dealt with it. And by now I can definitely write songs that give me that sort of, or get me out of like myself as far as the dark times. And then number three is, you know, positive forward thinking. Meaning, think about the life you're gonna live once you get good at these verses. Think about, you know, the videos that you're gonna shoot. Think about the girls you're gonna get. Think about the whatever car, whatever you want. Or maybe if you're more of like a conscious MC, like think about the lives you're gonna affect And don't focus so much on your current circumstances. I mean, it's sort of, to use another personal example, I'm still a student here at UCLA. I still live out here in LA. You know, when I want to travel the world, that's like one of my big things, and I have a little, but I want more. And so at times, you know, when I'm working on how to rap, but I'm in class, or like I'm in class and thinking about how to rap, I have to think, oh, it's gonna feel so good when I graduate, got that degree, about to be traveling, you know, helping people, teaching people how to rap, like da 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 da. Like, give yourself that speech, because no one else is gonna give you that speech. Not your mom, not your buddy, not other rappers, damn sure not other rappers, because they don't want you to live that life. So, you know, like, do that forward thinking. What kind of rapper are you gonna be? How are you gonna affect lives? What are your songs gonna sound like? Is you writing those rhymes? Tell us, you know. That's what some of the best rappers do. You know, they're like, yeah, when I get on, I'm gonna da-da-da-da-da, you know? Or I'm gonna change lives through da-da-da-da-da, you know? And, or if they're already successful, of course, they tell you, you know, how it felt back in the day. You think about Eminem, Jay-Z, Tupac, Nas, they all discuss their previous lives extensively. Now, you should do the same, but flip it. Talk about your future life. Talk about what you're gonna be, not what you are right now, you know, because what you are right now is just a set of circumstances. What you're gonna be is something that you built yourself with hard work, dedication, and a level of focus that you're exhibiting through your raps, writing it right now. So with that being said, hope this is helpful. You know, be sure to use your competitive spirit. Be sure to visualize, and of course, be sure to write when you're in that dark time. Don't fucking sit around and mope or watch too much Love and Hip Hop. Goddamn Basketball Wives, fuck them, they're not paying you. Your raps are paying you, so write them. That being said, I'm off. Drew Marcy, I'm out. Peace.